Hey guys, this is Arte, and I'm happy to announce the release of the Lossless Adapter, a Gamecube to USB adapter tailored for Smash. For starters, it uses a single detachable USB-C cable while still supporting Rumble. It's also very portable, thanks to being so small it fits in your pocket. When it comes to performance, long story short, it's the fastest option on every platform and has some perks on top of that. For instance, for Melee, it's plug and play on Windows. You don't need to install drivers, you don't need to overclock the adapter. No messing with the BIOS, no issues with anti-cheats, no Windows updates randomly nuking the overclock. There are no better ports and pulling doesn't slow down when you play doubles. You just plug it in and get the best experience, no arcane knowledge required. For PC, if you care about playing games on your GameCube controller, you may enjoy the fact that it uses X input, the same protocol as Xbox controllers, which in practice means it's natively compatible with virtually everything. As for Ultimate, well, first of all, the latency gap is pretty significant. It's multiple milliseconds faster than the official adapter, which is the current fastest option. As for the non-official options, they are doing their best. But this isn't even the main thing. The main thing is that it's the only device that doesn't mess with your inputs. Have a look at this. I've spoofed a GameCube controller and I've made it so it repeatedly presses Y and A 34 frame lengths apart. If the inputs come out 34 frames apart, the NAR will whiff. 33 frames apart, it will hit. 35 frames apart, it will auto-cancel. Since it's doing the perfect timing for the inputs to come out 34 frames apart, you would expect to see only whiffs. But this isn't what's happening. The thing is, on Switch, with any controller regardless of whether they're wired, the amount of time your inputs take to reach the game is slightly random. This is a problem, because it means it's possible for two inputs to be delayed by different amounts of time, and thus lose the meaning they had relatively to one another. So for instance, if you repeatedly jump and attack with precisely the same gap in between every time, your attacks won't always come out the same time relatively to your jumps. This is what you're witnessing right now. So here I've got the audio recording of a DKNR test. On over 64,000 measures, 25.7% of the time, it's not a whiff. This is not fine. If things were working properly, every single one of these would be a whiff. Because doing two inputs some amount of frame lengths apart should result in them coming out that amount of frames apart. Overall, according to my measures, if a player has the quality of execution that would make them succeed at a frame perfect technique 90% of the time, in Ultimate, on all current controllers, they will only succeed at most 75% of the time. The lossless adapter, as the name implies, considerably reduces that issue. Now, this is all well and good, but should you care? Is it actually going to make a difference? Well, Melee players would have something to say about that. In late 2020, I introduced adapter overclocking to the Melee scene, which is the usage of HID USBF, a custom driver meant for gaming mice developed by Sweetlow to convince your PC to sample your GameCube to USB adapter more often. The effects of which are almost the same as what I've been describing, except the initial situation on Switch is worse. As for whether it makes a difference, listen on.
Our next topic, the Pulfix. Overclocking the controller. Pulfix is a way to literally hack your controller using a driver meant for gaming mice. Basically, it makes things a bit more consistent, feel a bit more smooth. So I guess I've tried it. Have you guys tried it? And if so, how do you feel?
I tried it today. And I didn't notice it at first because I was playing this Mario on Unranked. But then... Yeah.
Okay, yeah, go on.
But it's definitely smoother. I feel like I'm hitting pivots more consistently. I don't know if that's placebo or not.
I think pivots are definitely one of the big ones.
Yeah, it felt like... I was practicing on my CRT because I thought I was going crazy and I was hitting it way more frequently. And then this thing came out and it felt like the same for like the pivot success rate.
Mango, have you felt anything?
Oh, no, it's nice. It's literally, I turned on my CRT to compare and it wasn't quite CRT, but it's pretty fucking close, dude. Like the fact that I can play someone, you know, Zane, for example, we haven't tried it, but I'm sure it's going to be just as buttery. And I think we're to the point where I think with this and Slippy, I think it's pretty legit.
And speaking of PC Melee being legit, this brings me to the last major feature. The lossless adapter embeds a lag tester that makes it very easy to check whether your setup has any issues. And in fact, I'm going to demonstrate that right now. So you open the application that comes with the adapter, you click on test lag. There's a pop-up with instructions, and after that, Slippi will open, and after a few seconds, magic will happen. To be clear, I'm not doing anything right now, I don't even have a controller plugged in. We should end up in-game with a white background, and then we'll put the adapter on the screen at middle height and press the button. So you wait about a minute, and then you press the button again to stop it, and you exit Slippi. And you should get a pop-up like this. Well, hopefully a little better than mine. The lag tester is not very happy with my setup right now. It's telling me that I have 40 milliseconds more lag than console CRT, that basically my setup is ass. But the nice thing is it's telling me why. So if I look down there, I'm going to see a few comments from the lag testing application on my setup. So first it's telling me that my polling rate is 500, which is weird because the adapter is native 1000. So I probably have the classic Ryzen bug. So it's telling me how to fix it. And then it's going to comment on my monitors. So apparently I have monitors and can be configured to 280Hz and it's configured to 60. So it also tells me how to fix it. Finally, it's going to tell me about my Slippi configuration. And apparently I'm rendering the emulation to the main Dolphin window, which is bad. And I'll also have VSync on, which is not necessarily bad. It's a trade-off between tearing and lag. So as you can see, this lag tester doesn't just measure the lag down to gray levels. It also judges if your setup seems to have performance as good as what your hardware affords. And it actively looks for things that may hurt your experience. The idea is that there are way too many things that can cause issues, and Smash is a very demanding game, right? Execution, reaction, speed. And it's very common to wonder whether things aren't going well because of you or because of your setup. This aims to put an end to such doubts. If you suspect something is wrong, you run a test. It takes 2 minutes. Of course, it will never catch every possible issue, but it catches a lot. It sees the PC to adapter communication, it sees any variations in the end-to-end lag, it sees your Slippi configuration, your monitor configurations. Chances are, if it tells you your setup is fine, your setup is fine. And with that said, I believe we're done. Of course, these are only the main features, there's also smaller stuff like remapping. You can get more details on my website, input-integrity.com, which is also where you'll be able to buy these. I intend to drop the first batch this Friday the 3rd at 10 PM CET, and shipping will be happening in the next few weeks. I already have all the adapters on hand, so little risk of delay there. However, there's always the possibility some bugs remain I would have been unable to see during development. I only have so many switches and controllers. For that reason, but also so that I can add new features in the future, the adapters have a built-in firmware updater. Updating the firmware takes a couple button clicks in the same app that lag tests are launched from, and I will distribute firmware updates on my website and on Discord. This Discord will serve as a hub for all things related to the lossless adapters, news, firmware updates, guides, questions. I also figure it would be interesting to share the results of our lag tests and share any findings of interest. I think having widespread accessible lag testers opens the doors to a community effort to better understand how setups perform. So if you're interested in any of this, you should definitely join. And finally, I hope you all enjoy. For a bit of trivia, I've been working on this for multiple years. It all began with the release of Smash Ultimate. I wanted to do an open source task bot that would be useful for people to train and explore in-game mechanics. By the end of December, the project was done. And if you've never heard of it, that makes sense, because I never published it, because it didn't work, it would desync in seconds, and by now it should be very clear why. But back then to me it wasn't, so I searched why and how to fix it. And as that search went on, it had a few side effects. I quickly realized melee emulation had the very same issues, and that false positives and negatives in the feedback loop of people training on PC were slowing their progress, which felt very unfair. So as I learned about USB, I set out to write a driver that would oversample the adapters. And while I was inquiring about driver stuff online, Sweetlow reached out to me and let me know that he had already done what I was trying to do. And the rest is history. But then, the input integrity on PC was still not as good as it could theoretically be. So I made the radio stemming dispersion devs. But then, these would add some input lags that on paper could be avoided. So I made Crystal, which fixed that. But then, digital controllers didn't work with Crystal because they were HID, so I made Pico Rectangle that spoofed an adapter. And so, every new project over these last few years taught me new things that eventually led up to my being able to go back and fix the project I could never get to work. By making an adapter that not only works well, but manipulates the switch into working properly. I hope it will make the game feel better, and most importantly, I hope it will make people have more fun. See you next time.